come on. Yeah, come on. Yeah, right.
Hello one and all, my name is Rio and welcome to another Matchday vlog. So tonight, Chester FC make the trip to Greater Manchester yet again as we play Cheadle Town away, where we look to record our first win of pre-season. So with us playing away at Marine in less than 48 hours, so in 2 days time on Saturday, I do think we will play a significantly weaker team tonight, so maybe a mixture of youth, some fringe and maybe some more trialists too. So I do think it will be quite a weak team tonight, and maybe we will play quite a similar team on Saturday than we did at Radcliffe last weekend. So really can't wait for it now, because it will be a double header for me, because I will be off to both games. So really can't wait now, and also two new stadiums to boot too. So yeah, looking forward to of course Cheadle tonight and of course Marine on Saturday. So of course I do hope you all enjoy my match day vlog today. If you do, please like, subscribe and also comment down your thoughts of the game below. So without further ado, let's get into tonight's match day vlog right now. Enjoy. Like Radcliffe, Cheadle Town are well into their pre-season campaign and will have a lot of match fitness amongst their ranks, while I don't think we've even had a training session yet. So hopefully as our pre-season schedule does come along, we will get a lot more better. So anyway, of course, our last match was on Saturday as we lost 3-1 away at Radcliffe in our opening game of pre-season, in what was quite a decent workout for us. We were second best in the first half, as Radcliffe's increased match fitness shown, as they were by far the better team and were in our faces right from the start. Luke Navarro got the only goal of the half to make it 1-0 to Radcliffe and to give them a deserved lead, as he fired into the far right hand corner off the post to make it 1-0 and also to give Louis Gray no chance. A mass overhaul at half time ensued, as we had a completely different side for the second half, so we were a little bit better in my opinion, but I would still say that Radcliffe just about shaded it, and it was Radcliffe who did make it 2-0 in what was a rather unfortunate moment for Trailist F, because a moment before he did miss a really good chance for us to get an equaliser. However, a minute later at the other end, he scored an own goal to make it 2-0 despite his best efforts to clear the ball off the line, because the free kick on the right hand side came in and unfortunately for him the ball bounced off him. And it was Radcliffe who sealed the win to make it 3-0 before full time, as former Chester FC player Rain Helliwell, who I did choose in my key player in my matchday preview last week, simply tapped into the top left hand corner to make it 3-0 to Radcliffe, as defensively it was a really poor show by us, as we were outnumbered and also outdone by a really strong home attack. However, with moments to go before full time, we did manage to get a mere consolation to put a bit of respect on the scoreline, as Danny Elliott slotted home into the bottom right hand corner for us to make it 3-1. It was too little too late though, as we could have no complaints with the final scoreline. So anyway, if you do want to watch all of the goals from Saturday, then make sure to head over to my matchday preview, which was out yesterday evening. It will take about 45 minutes to get to Cheadle from here, so it will be quite a short journey, although with it being a midweek game and also with me going on the train, it might take me a little bit longer tonight, so I will be back quite late, about 12:30, so yeah, quite a late one for me, but anyway, I'd do anything to watch Chester, so yeah, really can't wait now, and also I have never been to Cheadle before, so can't wait to visit my 78th stadium. So another one ticked off my list, hopefully. So anyway, Cheadle Town play at the Park Road Stadium, which holds 2000, so quite a basic stadium. It is basically a field really with one really small stand, but I do suppose Cheadle do play some four leagues below us, so I don't really expect it to be the Allianz Arena or whatever. So yeah, it's not the best, but oh well. I suppose I have been to worse, by the way, but not too many worse anyway. So anyway, on one side is a covered all-seater stand, which goes for about one third of the pitch and also straddles the halfway line. So quite a narrow stand, but also it is quite tall too. So yeah, a bit of an odd stand, but oh well, it is better than nothing. So yeah, that goes for about one third of the pitch, and also to make up the remaining two thirds of the pitch, so to both the left and also to the right hand side of the seated stand, you do have two uncovered flat standing areas. Meanwhile, opposite that is another uncovered flat standing area, but this time it does go for the entire length of the pitch, so basically it is just a grass verge basically. Meanwhile, behind one goal is another uncovered flat standing area, which again is a really similar feature, although you do have a bit of a wall at the back of the stand as well, because I do believe there are a few houses too, so maybe to stop the ball from going into the gardens. And also finally, behind the other goal is yet another uncovered flat standing area, which is a really similar affair, although you don't have a wall this time. So anyway, I highly doubt tonight's game will be segregated, but in the highly unlikely event segregation is in place, then us Chester FC supporters will be allocated the uncovered flat standing area to the right hand side of the seated stand, and also a small section of the seated stand as well. But anyway, regardless of that, really can't wait, and hopefully we can record our first win of pre-season. Cheadle Town play four leagues below us in the North West Counties League, Division 1 South, where they will be hoping to mount a promotion bid this season. Of course, their campaign was voided last season due to COVID-19, although they did manage to secure a respectable 8th place finish, so they will be wanting to build on that this time out. Our Lancashire opponents will also be starting afresh this season, as Lloyd Morrison was appointed as their new manager at the beginning of August, so he has only been in the hot seat for a few weeks, so it will be interesting to see how they fare with the new manager. We have locked horns with Cheadle Town once before, which was way back on November the 7th, 2012, as we won 4-2 away in the Cheshire Senior Cup first round. So hopefully, fingers crossed, we will be able to emulate our formidable record tonight, and hopefully we can get another 6-goal thriller, because another 6-goal thriller wouldn't go amiss either. My score forecast for tonight's game is Cheadle Town 1, Chester FC 2. So for Cheadle, I think my key player, Pat Davin, will score for them, while for the Seals, I think Lloyd Marsh Hughes and also Will Goodwin will be both of our scorers tonight. So I do think it will be quite a convincing away win tonight, and also I do think we will manage to get the job done, considering I do think we will play quite a weakened side. So hopefully my score forecast will be right and we will be able to record our first victory of pre-season. Anyway, my matchday vlog will be coming up right now, showing you all of the action, so stay tuned. So anyway, of course, I do hope you all enjoy today's matchday vlog. If you do, please like, subscribe, and also comment down your thoughts of the game below. So come on, City, let's do this. Tears are not enough. Tears are not enough. Tears are not enough. I have now arrived at the Park Road Stadium ahead of tonight's game between Cheadle Town and Chester FC, so quite a nice evening for it, which is the complete polar opposite of Radcliffe away on Saturday, which was absolutely freezing cold, but thankfully it is quite a nice mild evening tonight. So my journey from Chester to Cheadle Hume via Crewe and also Stockport went rather well, so really can't wait for the game now. And quite surprisingly, we have named a rather strong team again tonight, so I think we will have one team who will play in the first half, and also I do think a completely different side will play the second half as well, which is rather surprising considering we do have Marine away on Saturday. But again, really can't wait, and I really can't wait to see how our team are faring ahead of the new season, and also I am looking forward to seeing how some of our trialists also do tonight. So a nice ground as well, really nice stand to the left of me too. The pitch is really good too, a really lovely surface, so again, no excuses tonight. But anyway, looking forward to the game now. Come on, City. Come on, City. Here is your Chester FC team for the first half. We are in a 4-4-2 formation. So in goal is Louis Gray. In defence is Trialist A, Trialist B, Trialist C and Joel Taylor. In midfield is Kevin Roberts, Trialist D, George Glendon and Brad Jackson. And up front are Anthony Dudley and Lloyd Marsh Hughes. So enjoy the vlog. Come on, you Seals. Come on, Blue Boys! God. What a start. Unlucky. Good save. Go on, Jacko. Come on now. Oh. Good ball. Going now, finish. Oh! Go on, finish! Yes! Come on! Get in, Lloyd. Great finish. Go on, finish! Yes! Any time today? Hey! Bloody hell. Oh, hey, ref! Surely.
Right shoulder.
Oh God. Oh, go on, good turn now, shoot. Oh, I've got to hit it. Oh, go on now, you're in. Oh, unlucky. Oh. Go on, Jacko. Oh. Come on now. Oh, go on. Yes! Come on! Get in. Yeah! Oh, he's flapped it. Go on now, get the rebound! Hit it! Ah. Go on. Ooh. Oh. Here is your Chester FC team for the second half. Again, we are in a 4-4-2 formation. So, in goal is John Worsenop. In defence is Jamie Morgan, Danny Livesey, Simon Grand and Trailist Steph. In midfield is Trailist G, Trailist H, Gary Roberts and John Johnston. And up front are Anthony Dudley and also Danny Elliott. Enjoy the second half. Come on, you Seals. One City. Oh, go on now, finish it. Go on. Oh, unlucky.
Gail.
Finish. Oh. Shoot! Oh. Oh. Oh, go on now. Oh, oh no. Yes, Garrett, get in. Come on. Oh no. Yes, Garrett, get in. Go on, I'll get a four. Hit it. Oh. Good ball, now finish. Yes, get in, Danny. Excellent goal. Finish. Yeah. Oh. Oh! Thank you. Oh, good save. Oh. Go on, finish, surely, oh dear me. Hey! Get in. Go on, Danny. Yes, get in. Yes, get in. Cheadle Town 1, Chester FC 6, so what a fantastic win for us tonight, because we were by far the better team and a really encouraging performance by us too. So anyway, what a fantastic win and also a fantastic away day too. So roll on Marine on Saturday and also more reaction to follow shortly. Come on City. Cheadle Town 1, Chester FC 6. So it is now 12:30 in the morning, so I have only now just got back from Cheadle, so I will have to make my matchday analysis as quick as I can. But anyway, it was a really mad journey coming back home. But anyway, yeah, what a fantastic away at the end, all in all. It was well worth it. So on the whole, much more encouraging on the whole last night as we blew Cheadle Town apart after a rather disappointing opening few moments of the game to record an excellent win. On the whole as well, it was a really professional display by us as we zipped the ball around really well and also had enough chances to take our tally to double figures really, because it was so easy. There were also plenty of really good individual performances too, while a couple of our trialists also impressed as well, so hopefully they will be given more chances as pre-season goes on, starting from Marina Way tomorrow. So Cheadle Town weren't a bad side in the opening few moments of the game, as they caused us a few issues and also were quite decent on both wings. But once we unlocked them, they lost their confidence and they just never recovered after that. So all in all, a really good performance tonight. The first half was a really mixed bag as Cheadle Town began as the better side, but after their goal went in, we went on to boss the contest. It was Cheadle Town who did make it 1-0 with the opening chance of the game, as Big Pat Davin, who I did choose as my key player in my matchday preview a few days ago, slotted into the bottom corner after a Louis Gray parry. A few moments later, we went in search for a response, but Kevin Roberts glanced a header wide while at the other end, Louis Gray pulled off a superb save to stop Davin from getting his second of the game. As the half went on, we grew into the game more and more as we were much more useful and careful when in possession, which resulted in more chances coming our way. Firstly, Brad Jackson was really close to finding an equaliser as his attempt was palmed over by the Cheadle custodian after a nice interchange with Joel Taylor. A couple of moments later, we finally found that equaliser as Lloyd Marsh Hughes finished off a lovely move for us to make it 1-1. Lloyd was also involved in another nice passage of play in the lead up to the interval as his cross found Brad Jackson, who chested down towards George Glendon, who blazed over. With minutes to go before half time, we did manage to take the lead in bizarre fashion as a Cheadle defender struck the ball against Trialist C, whose touch was enough to make it 2-1 to us. All in all, a poor start gave us the kick up the backside we needed as we eventually found our rhythm to have a deserved lead at half time. Our performance in the second period was even better as we dominated the entirety of the half to cruise past a hapless Cheadle Town outfit. We did miss a fair few chances in the first half, but our finishing was much more clinical in the second 45, while we were much more effective on both flanks too. In the opening few moments of the period, Danny Elliott did smash the ball into the back of the net for us, although unfortunately his effort was chalked off for offside. Elliott was also unlucky to not have extended our lead as he saw a shot saved by Cheadle's keeper, although we did manage to put further daylight between us and the hosts as Trialist H eventually lashed home for us to make it 3-1 after a bit of pinball in the penalty area. This was the first of three goals in a matter of minutes, as Danny Elliott added further woe to our opponents to make it 4-1 to us, as he hammered home to give their goalie no chance. Just a minute later, another rather comical moment ensued, as Danny Livesey's long punt downfield resulted in Cheadle Town's Neil Chappell performing a backwards header, hence his own goal made it 5-1 to us, so a bit of a moment to forget for Neil Chappell. Meanwhile, John Johnston made a great cross in towards Danny Elliott, who was unable to convert as his effort was clipped over by an opposing defender, while Danny almost bagged his second of the clash with full-time edging nearer, but the home side's keeper pulled off a remarkable stop to deny his powerful header. The last action of the game saw Danny Elliott brought down for a penalty and he duly slotted home to secure his brace, which made it 6-1 to us. So all in all, a flawless second half performance gave us just rewards as we well and truly put Saturday's disappointing defeat at Radcliffe behind us. Many members of our side put in excellent performances yesterday evening, especially George Glendon, who goes down as my man of the match. Some of the balls he made in the centre of the park were superb, while his link-up play was brilliant too. Also, John Johnston was really impressive when he came on in the second period, as he was a menace out wide by constantly causing Cheadle Town problems, while his link-up play with Danny Elliott was also a joy to watch. Elliott himself again maintained his promising start to pre-season by netting a couple of tidy goals, and he could have scored a few more too had it not been for the heroics of the Cheadle goalkeeper. Also, Brad Jackson was back to his old best last night as his pacey runs down the left gave Cheadle a whole host of issues to deal with, while he also made some really good deliveries too. On the trialist front, the lad who we did have up top for the first half, who scored our goal to make it 2-1, who I do believe is former Accrington Stanley player Paddy Lacey, according to a couple on Diva Chat, well, he looked rather handy as he was involved in a couple of nice moves, and of course netted a really lucky goal too, so perhaps he may be worth another look at Marina Way tomorrow. And also the left winger we did have in the second half looked quite promising too, so maybe there is something in him. And also, I do believe former Stockport County midfielder Sam Walker played for us last night too, so if he is to play for more matches tonight, I'd be delighted, because I do think he would be an absolutely superb signing for our level. So hopefully it will be true that Sam Walker was one of our trialists last night, and if so, then he would be a superb player for us. Our next match is tomorrow, as we play Marina Way in what will be a tougher game than last night, although I can see us continuing our habit of fielding one team for each half as well. So I really can't wait now, because it is a nice little away day near Liverpool, so hopefully we will be able to record back-to-back wins. So anyway, I will be off to Marina Way, so really can't wait now. As I've said, I will be going to Marina Way tomorrow, so look out for a matchday preview, which may be out really late on tonight, if not Saturday morning, because I do have a hell of a busy schedule today, because of course it is 12:30 in the morning now, and of course I do have sixth form later on today, so sadly I won't really be able to edit my matchday vlog for Cheadle Town until after school really. So I do think my matchday vlog for Cheadle will be out later on tonight, then if that is the case, then I may have to upload my Marine matchday preview Saturday morning really, to space my schedule out a little bit. So it is a little bit of a pain really, considering we have had two matches in really quick succession, but hopefully it will be a little bit more straightforward from next week onwards. So anyway, can't wait for Marine now, and in general it is fantastic to have that winning feeling back again tonight, so hopefully we can use this confidence to carry on going now. So anyway, of course, I do hope you all enjoyed my matchday vlog tonight. If you did, please like, subscribe, and also comment down your thoughts of the game below. So see you all for Marina Way tomorrow. Come on, City! Get in!